Alright, so I'm grading inside this garage. It is 13 feet deep in there. So I benchmark off the garage door openings here. I'm at a, going down, I got it in inches, about 134 inches, which is 11 foot 2. And I've got a whole bunch of stone baled in here. So I am using the autos on here. Keep the bucket level at the bottom of the excavation, so all I can do is watch for my depth. Sorry, my big head's probably in the way of the Trimble screen. Grab stone out of this corner. Swiping. It's nice because the auto system is keeping the bucket leveled. Gets in. Is there something on the end of that pipe or?
Yeah.
Okay. This way? Lakeside. So luckily the guy bought the place next door right when we were starting the project. So you can see he drove right in there. Came around. run up the pile. Gonna have a nice view out here on the lake. On the outside, I'm gonna hit it with the wheel. Now this area here is gonna be a patio area on the first floor, or well, I don't know, you call it the basement maybe. And then the first floor, which is equal with a garage, will kind of have a porch over it and be fully enclosed, and then the second floor will be above that. Spin the wheel around when I'm working up against stuff because it sticks out, and so does the integrated grabber on the back. So I just spin it around so that way I don't accidentally hit anything. Thank you. get some dry dirt. So I am hopeful that we can be done backfilling today. You have a bit of work. I know it doesn't look like much. We still got a bit of work. We got two dry wells to put in. So, but we got a lot done. This is all filled. A lot of the stone's done in there. We've got a big pile of stone there to use for all down in here. Upgrading this patio area. Four inches down from concrete. Autos on the tilt rotator, so right now it's just holding level, so it's nice. It is a little difficult to kind of keep your eye on grade and also keep an eye on if the bucket is level, so it's nice that you kind of only have to focus on keeping it on grade. I really like the autos for the tilt rotator. Works on the back with the backwards bucket here, which is nice. I'm trying to leave it a little bit high because of compaction. Still putting stone on top, so as long as it's fairly close.